What is up? Today we're not in the car, so a little different, a little change of scenery. But I just made a video on Instagram on Reels about a lot of people are finding out about Ben Patrick, about knees over toes guy, the ATG system. And I was talking about, this idea that people seem to have that you should not take these joints to their full, and obviously the knee, to those extreme end ranges. And on Instagram there's only about, I think it was like 60 seconds, but I thought I would expound on it a little bit more here. Now, here's the thing. The reason that people think that you can't or you shouldn't go to those deep ranges is because A, there's pain when you go there. So when there's pain, the purpose of the pain is to stop you. Pain is protective. Tightness is protective. Your nervous system is saying there is a danger in this range, so that's where the pain starts. Or the pain is just there all the time, so then you don't even like that's where you can't move, right? So when you understand that, and then you think about there's no way I could go that deep in that split squat, or and that type of a lunge, or anything of that nature. Well, here's the thing. Number one, you have a understanding of pain that is not accurate and that is not helpful. Ben has done such a great job of putting together this understanding and this program, and more importantly, the philosophy and the structure around getting rid of pain. Getting rid of pain requires you first understanding it. And we're not actually trying to get rid of it. What we want to do is we want to be able to move and engage with life at a high level. And rather than think of that pain as something bad, right? Because from our human perspective, you're like, oh, that hurts. I can't do what I want to do. This sucks. And we get frustrated. And by the way, like I had a lot of experience with this because the whole reason I got into strength and conditioning was because I had back pain that was so bad that I couldn't walk in my early 20s. And the doctors couldn't do anything. The athletic trainers didn't know what to do. So I had to miss, long stretches of, like I played basketball in high school and college because I couldn't even walk, right? And literally a month into proper strength training, my pain disappeared. Literally within a year, I had deadlifted 405. From having excruciating back pain and never having strength trained to deadlifting 405 because the understanding of what is actually going on, okay? What is this system, right? And so, as far as going into these deep ranges and these deep lunges, and even like taking your dips all the way down where your elbow, where your shoulder is in its most extreme end range, where your elbow is all the way bent, right? The analogy that I really like, okay, number one, if you gotta understand that the pain is there to protect you. What is it protecting you from? The nervous system is understanding, the brain is understanding that at this range, there's not a lot of strength in the shoulder, in the muscles in the shoulder, and there's not a lot of control, motor control, right? And so my brain recognizes that, and then it stop, and then the pain signal turns on. So then I'm not gonna go and do dips like that. I won't be able to because the pain will be too great. What a beautiful system. What a beautiful system. Self-regulating. Now, since we don't understand it and we misinterpret it, then we turn it into something worse. But now, because, we understand these things, and people like Ben are sharing this stuff, and this is what I built my, the last 12 years of my coaching program is like about teaching people why this happens and how to not just get rid of pain, but move beyond that. If I start to tell my brain, hey, I have strength here and I have control here using good strength and conditioning, my brain says, oh, okay, this is safe, and it'll let me get a little bit more, it'll start to down or turn down the pain signal and get access to a little bit more range of motion. This is why people do a lot of stretching and they don't ever get rid of pain permanently or get any more flexible, because you're not building strength and control piece by piece. So now here's the thing. People get scared of this stuff and they don't want to do it, but the path forward is to expose those areas to new stresses. Now here's the next part of this. This building is held up by material, right? The architecture can hold a certain amount of weight. If you put on enough weight on the beams and the posts on this wall, eventually it's going to collapse, right? Because this architecture is not adaptive. It does not respond to the stress you place on it. Biological architecture, tendons, ligaments, muscle, bone. These things adapt to the stress and the load that you place on it. So as long as you don't try to put too much too fast, that architecture will start to remodel and adapt and get stronger, thicker, bigger in response to the loads. Now that's a key point there, because if you load it too fast, too quickly, because the biology can only adapt so quickly, right? If you try to go too fast, it's not gonna, like, you're gonna outpace the ability to adapt and the pain will increase. So you have to be patient, you have to be calm, you have to be relaxed, right? But if you can stay on a steady pace, that architecture will adapt, and not only will your pain dissipate as the nervous system is recognizing more strength and more control, but you'll actually gain deeper range, because the brain will let you, the nervous system will let you. You'll get stronger, you'll get more resilient to more loads, right? Because the architecture has adapted, right? A similar, if this wall could do the same, what it might look like is like if you place a bunch of weight on it, and then there would be somebody like, oh, doing a calculation, like, oh, the load has increased. Let's put reinforcements. Let's put like another set of 2x2, 2x4s on this side. And you put more load, and then they're like, okay, we need, two more 2x4s on front and back, right? That would be the equivalent. So hopefully, I know that this analogy will help. It will make sense, which is why if you do a strength and training, a strength and conditioning program, a strength training program that's put together well and you execute it well, you will get rid of pain. You will be able to do things you haven't done, been able to do before, right? And one thing that always sticks out to me, this is a really good one, is, bone, the only thing that actually makes bones more dense is loading them. This is why bodybuilders, weightlifters, all the people who load their skeletal system have the strongest bones. Like osteoporosis and bone problems don't exist in that population. Even myself, I went to go get, you can measure your bone density on a density on a DEXA scan. I was in the 99th percentile. I've been lifting for 15 years, right? And so if you logically think through this, like why would weightlifters and people who load their skeletal system, their bones be more dense? Because that architecture is adapting. You're placing the load, the biology is changing to adapt to that new stimulus, right? So hopefully that makes sense. We'll keep talking about this, but I can't recommend Ben's just everything that he shares enough, because he's done such a great job of like sharing this information in a very easy to understand, and he provides a great scaffolding to build your understanding, and then in turn build your body, right? As always, if you ever have questions, feel free to reach out. You can find me, on Instagram or email me or whatever. Leave a comment. Please like and subscribe. We want to share more. This is the strength method. The reason I changed the name from San Jose Barbell to the strength method is because strength is the key to a healthy life, okay? As George Hackenschmidt said, health can never be divorced from strength, okay? And I take that a step further and say, like, there's no healthy people who are also weak. If you're weak, you cannot be healthy, okay? So so strength is that foundation for everything. It allows you to do more things. And most importantly, like, what I say, and one of the reasons why I really appreciate Ben and everybody in that community, is because it's about treating people with respect, treating yourself with respect, treating people with kindness. And I always say the strongest thing that you can do is lift somebody else up, right? And I take that a step further. Before you can, like, lifting yourself up is the first piece, but sometimes, if you do it for somebody else, it helps you do it for yourself, okay? But anyways, I'll leave it at that. If you're interested in coaching or consultations or programs, feel free to message me. Find the link in the description. See everything there, all the stuff that we do. So, with that, Happy New Year, and I will see you here very soon.